Now talk about the positive rays or canal rays. While conducting experiments on the gas discharge in 1886, German physicist E. Goldstein discovered that if the cathode ray is used, perforated luminous streams appeared in the tube behind the cathode. These streams are called canal rays. Over here, the canal rays will be created. So the tube contains an anode, a perforated cathode, and a fluorescent screen. At a pressure of about 1 mm of mercury, a luminous stream of particles were absorbed behind the cathode, proceeding in a direction opposite to that of the cathode rays. That's referred to as your positive rays. Goldstein called them as canal rays. Since they pass through and emerge from the holes in the cathode in straight lines opposite to the direction of the cathode rays, from the nature of the deflection produced by a magnetic field or electric field, these rays were found to be positively charged particles. Hence, canal rays are most commonly known as positive rays. Canal rays are the streams of positive ions of the gas enclosed in the discharge tube. The mass of each ion is nearly equal to the mass of the atom. They are deflected by the electric and magnetic fields. The deflection is opposite to that of the cathode rays. You are able to see the positive ions here is behind the cathode rays, cathode with the holes. This is a positive ion, this is electrons. Further moving towards the properties of canal rays travel in straight line. The velocity of canal rays is much smaller than the velocity of the cathode ray. You can see the cathode rays in one direction, your canal rays in another direction. The cathode with holes, this is the cathode with holes, is a PS disc. And this is nothing, your positive ion, and this one is gas molecules. It's vacuum tube, and these are electrons moving towards your anode. So canal rays are used and it can affect photographic plates, and they are able to produce a fluorescence. They ionize the gas through which they pass. That's the advantage and properties of canal rays.